Fuck, man. Yash, where the fuck is he, dude?
Dude, I don't know what to do at this point. He's always late.
Man, like, I take my fucking precious time out of my fucking day, and he's still late, man. And I'm not even getting paid, you know? What the fuck?
Dude, you think I'm getting paid? Can't do anything about it, man.
Am I? Alright. They can wait.
Dude, it's 10 o'clock. Where the hell is this guy?
Dude. Where the fuck is this guy? What the fuck? I'm still here? It's been like 2 hours, man.
Dude, I got shit to do, man. I'm literally ready to leave.
Dude, like, what the fuck, man? Let's just get our shit and go. We should fucking quit, you know? Fuck this shit, man.
I agree with you, man. I'm ready to quit.
Where the fuck have you been, man? I was waiting for you.
Waiting for you?
Like, fuck, you showed up, man.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back to the show. Fuck you, Sandeep, by the way.
Yeah, fuck you.
What? What do you mean you're gonna bounce on me, dude?
Alright, hurry the fuck up, man, so we can start the actual show. Nobody cares about your fucking monologue, you know? You're not fucking Bojack.
So let's talk about making plans, huh? I have some friends who are so bad at making plans, it's fucking unbelievable. You like that one, Sandeep? One time I had a friend, he texted me, hey, you want to meet up tonight? I said, yeah, sure, where? No response. A few hours go by, you know, 20 minutes before we have to meet, he goes, hey, we're on the way, see you there. And I go, where? What? You think I'm going to fucking sniff him out like a dog?
Are you done?
I thought that was fucking hilarious. I thought that was like comedy of the year, dude. I thought that was comedy of the year. You have a response?
Are you done? So
okay,
we can
fine.
Start?
Yeah, okay. Let's just cut.
Untrained meteorologist reporting on the snow. I mean, it's in the streets. God damn!
Welcome back. Today we got a famous international weatherman by the name of Blue Greenberg. And today he's going to talk to us about weather patterns, cirrus clouds, and how you can stay safe during a hurricane. So right now, let's cut to our dear friend Blue. Blue, can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear.
That's great, Blue. What have you got for us today? It seems like you've already misspelled the word weather report. Should I be concerned?
No, it's crystal clear, as it should be.
Is this how you spell it in Denmark?
No, this is how it should be.
Okay, proceed.
Here, we have Europe. Nice weather.
Is that all?
It's warm in the south and cold in the north.
That's an interesting, okay. We'll keep going.
Keep going, alright. Here we have cold and colder.
Can I just stop you? Can I just stop you for a second? Did you have to get a degree to do this or what?
No. I did favors.
Okay, continue.
Continue? Oh, this is private. Don't worry. Yep, here we have Thailand. Nice and, yeah. You know, it's very green.
There are a lot of trees here.
And then there's ice up in the north and ice down in the south.
There's ice down in the south, you said?
Yeah.
Of Thailand, there's ice in the south of Thailand. A weather, yeah. A place, okay.
I mean, it's blue in the north and blue in the south.
And that means ice?
Yes.
Is that you watching a man have a private moment with the car from Cars?
I mean, we have Lightning McQueen. He's gonna make me go vroom vroom.
You met Lightning McQueen?
I met him a lot of times.
Blue, did you meet Lightning McQueen? Are you telling me that you met Lightning McQueen in real life?
Not just in real life. Yep. I've had it real tough. Oh. That's private. Very private.
And that's it then.
The Jews do not control weather. If they did, what's Blitzkrieg?
Alright. Okay. Well, that was our weather report from Mr. Blue Greenberg. Now let's go to a commercial break while I figure out what I'm doing on this show. And we'll be back with an interview with Mr. Virasit Singh. Thank you.
Today, we mourn not only a man, not only a doctor, but a doctor man, who did what he loved until his very last breath. Bud Visseldorf, PhD, author, writer, poet. Some say he was the next Che Guevara and Freud. Others say he was just a crazy man who spent too much time on the internet in his underwear. But we all know he was all those things, yet also with so many potentials left behind. Bud made his career by writing several hit books and novellas in the early 2015s, diving deep and providing much wisdom on the topic of the glorious foot. Some say his obsession, his love for feet, drove him far down a dark path. And it's true, Bud did live a fast-paced Hollywood lifestyle like many famouses of his era. But he was and is much more than his faults and many, 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 many failures. He was an intellectual, a brilliant mind. His love of feet and his dedication to the study of pedestrian neurology will never be matched by any boy, girl, or other. Bud Visseldorf, a true pioneer, a revolutionary. He may not be living anymore, but he is still alive in our hearts.
What a long week it's been. Welcome back from the break. We got our interview coming up
this
next.
This motherfucker took 2 hours. 2 fucking hours. To arrive. 2 hours late. Go on.
You done?
Yeah, go on, dude.
You said what you wanted to say?
Yeah.
You good? You talked it out?
Yeah.
Get it out. Get it all right now.
Yeah,
get your emotions out. Fuck it, do it on camera.
We're gonna work together anyway, so. You wanna.
Alright. Don't talk during my intro.
All right.
All right, well, welcome back. We got Mr. Virasit Singh here today, a dear friend of ours, dear friend of the show, and he's coming in right now. We're gonna talk to him.
What's up?
What is it?
Just go around. No, just.
That's what happens when you're fucking studios.
You fuckers.
Dude, fucking water everywhere, man.
Yeah, what's the story about that water?
It's yours.
No, I mean.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, that was earlier.
Okay.
I was in a bit of a rush, couldn't get up, had to go, so I went.
Well,
it's all mine, baby.
Man, I have no idea why the fuck you would agree to be here, but here we are.
So, world's greatest dad, huh? Best dad ever.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. No, so we got Vera here. I feel like he's a very level-headed man.
Yeah.
Knows a lot about various topics and things.
I agree.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So I thought he could just come in and help us sort out whatever this, you know, before I showed up.
Dude, there's no point, man. After this, I'm getting the fuck out of here.
What the fuck is this? You're making me look like a fool over here on my fucking show.
Can you at least pay me?
You're not paying this guy.
You are speaking shit to me.
There's no point, man.
So how do you guys think
you can
demonstrate to each other that there's trust in this relationship?
I got a little gift to impart over here.
Okay.
Sandeep, this is for you.
What the fuck is this, man?
It's a peace offering.
I don't need this guy, you know?
My life, my rules. My style, my attitude. You love me or hate me, I don't care. But don't play with me.
We invited him here to be a guest and now he's just in the middle of it. Come on, man.
Hey, let's go through a few topics.
Sure,
let's have you impart some wisdom on them. Would you like to watch Sandeep smoke some ants?
Wait. Why would I smoke ants? You smoke ants.
What is that meant to even feel like?
Ask him, man.
Okay, I'm not sure. Because I've never smoked ants in my life.
Do you want to smoke ants and look
but,
like that? You guys are awesome shit, right?
Yo,
here, man.
I just want to say
smoking ants, bro.
No, let me just clear the record. I've never smoked ants in my life. But, if I did... I would say that the best thing to do when smoking ants is watch this show because you'll understand it better. Now, take with that what you will. I can't speak from first-hand experience, but just trust me.
You know what? I can agree with that.
Yeah, this is a certified message from three Indian boys right here.
Smoke ants.
This is the last episode.
Key to success.
Though.
Hey, dude, can you not talk when he's interrupted?
I'm sorry, man.
We got a guest here.
I'm not gonna be here.
You keep saying that. And I'm not sure. I'm not like.
I just wanna get some respect that is earned to me, you know? Respect that you've never given me.
Why? By coming late?
Yeah, because you're just being a dick all the time, man.
It's my show. I can come late. Is that wrong?
I think it's disrespectful.
My name is on the fucking show, bro.
Don't put him,
it's about me.
Don't put him in the middle of this, man.
Well, you think
get,
it's about
get
the fucking
it,
guest?
So
like,
I
could literally Photoshop any face, you know? Like, people come for this.
What, deep fake?
You are a deep fake, Sandeep. Fucking walked into that one. Vera, give us a little talk on influencers. Do you think that they're the poison of society or the cure?
I think it's just a product of the
Jeez.
World. Right? Like, you've got all of these apps which are connecting the world like never before. And so there's going to be, just like when you're in high school...
Dude, pay fucking attention, man.
There's going to be people at the top who others have to idolize, right?
Yeah. Yo, Baba, how's the food tasting?
Oh, this stuff is buzzing. Respectfully, no kizzy.
Oh, what about you, Abuji?
So what do you think about female influencers?
Female influencers, I mean, I
I can't lie.
Look at him. Look at him.
Look
at him.
Look at that smile. At the same time,
I've never seen a female in my life. Real life is more like this. Three sad men on a balcony, wondering, how am I gonna move on with life tomorrow? Should I even try?
You should, dude. You should. Because I'm not gonna be here.
What's sad
though? Okay, let me rephrase that. I'm the sad one!
Alright, let's continue with this shit.
Come.
Okay, we got a question from a fan, actually. So, didn't know someone watched this show. But...
Yeah, why would you watch this show? What the fuck are you doing smoking abs?
Anyway, Oscar Zafar Giles writes, I got a phone stuck in my anus. How do I get it out? Thank you for the question, Oscar.
I think you're asking the wrong guys.
No, Vera, you can tell us.
Maybe sprinkle some rice on your table? I don't know.
I do have a golden rule. My golden rule is if you lose anything, you do two things. One, check your own anus. If it's not there, check the person next to you. That's like 90% you'll be able to find it.
Actually, real quick, can I ask a rebound question? Is that possible?
Yeah.
How the fuck did you get it stuck up your ass in the first place, my god?
You should let us know, man.
Yeah. I actually really want to know. And I don't want to know the context.
And how will tell you?
Yeah,
was
the camera on? Was the camera on?
Was the camera on? Can
you
show us? What were you trying to get up there, bro?
Yeah.
We're gonna get some inside footage.
Let us know. Reach out at the email below. Anyone has an inquiry or anything, let us know. The God one?
Yeah.
That was good?
Yeah, Jesus.
Okay. We got a question now from a man. His name is Jesus.
Jesus?
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
And he says, are you a good boy? Hero, are you a good boy?
What is good? What is bad?
What is good? What is bad?
Yeah.
I know Sandeep's been bad, giving me all this shit.
Well, fuck you, man. You deserve it.
Gave him a platform, made him famous, made him a star.
I made you in this town. This is a hostile work environment, dude.
We need
a
HR.
Bit of toxicity going on.
Yeah, dude. I mean, after this show, well, hopefully that was the last fucking question so I can get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, he keeps saying that. He keeps saying he's gonna leave. There's no way he's gonna leave.
I'm fucking out of here, man.
No. Okay, thank you for coming on. I really appreciate it.
It's actually a
really wonderful interview.
Thank you. I appreciate it. It's been fun.
Yeah, so let's cut to whatever's coming up next, and we'll be back after this.
Why the fuck would you come on, man? Why the fuck would you do this show with this fucking...
He's my boy.
Dumbass, man. You know he's fucking
crazy,
right?
Dude,
I'm fucking out of here, man.
No, cameras are off. You don't need to do the joke.
I'm not doing the joke. I'm fucking off, man.
No, it's
you,
off.
Man.
Yash, when you stop filming, we're good.
You don't believe me?
No, dude. I thought it was a bit for the show. Come on. No, Sneak, you're such a dick. Don't fucking do this.
You fucking went over me.
You literally went...
Laugh now, bitch. I'm fucking out of here, dude. Fuck you. Do you think I'm joking?
Yeah, I do. It came like once.
There's multiple times.
I mean, last week
you're
and this
fucked.
Week, but like, you know.
You're just fucked. You don't remember it.
Bye-bye.
That's what you get for fucking treating me like shit, man. I can't wait to get
you know
the
what?
Fuck
you
out
know
of
what?
Here.
Next time you want my stash of ants, don't come and ask.
Fuck off,
okay?
Man.
I got fucking 2 kilos.
Fuck you.
Co-host, bro?
I'm good, man.
Sorry about that. I think he had an off day.
Yeah, man. It'll be good.
Thank you for doing it.
Of course. Hey, it's been good.
Yeah.
It's been good to see you, man. And hit me up. I'll hit you up, yeah?
Yeah.
It'll blow over. Just give him time. Yeah. It'll blow over. It'll be good. Don't worry about it.
You good?
Okay.
to stay? You need to stay?
I guess so.
Suddenly, everything.